just gonna do one more test shot just to make sure that this works. So this is my tester. If this works, we will go with it. Okay, so today we are gonna be doing a get to know me video. I wanted to do this a long time ago, really, because I've been on YouTube for quite a while. A couple years ago, I was doing my braces journey and I vlogged that, and I'm probably gonna have to revisit it, to be honest, because I lost my retainer for like a week and a half. I had to get a new one, things shifted. Another video for another time. So I wanted to jump in and just do some get to know me questions. So I put it on my Instagram for you guys to send me some questions, and I got some pretty good ones. And then also I went online and I found a couple of questions that I thought was kind of good too. So let's just jump right in. We'll start off with an Instagram question. So one question said, I may have overlooked it, but what pushed you to vlog? I want to, but I'm kind of scared. So like I said, I did my my braces vlogs a lot, like about 2 years ago. And I thought it was kind of cool. I mean, I really like to kind of take people along on the journey with me. And also, like, I'm kind of the type of friend that's like always taking pictures of moments, and I have like photo albums all over the place. My computer is like labeled and organized based off of photos and events, and so I always really like to document different like moments in my life. I just haven't necessarily put it all out there to the public, so I figured, I don't know, I just kind of wanted to do it. And then the other thing that kind of like stopped me before is because my boyfriend is kind of a private person and I'm a lot more open than he is. But recently I just kind of was like, well, you know, there's a lot of things that I do, you know, by myself, and then also there are some things that we kind of do together that I don't necessarily have to like put him in the vlog, you know, fully. He doesn't mind like if he pops up, but he's probably not going to do like a full-on cameo or nothing like that. But I kind of just really like it and I just wanted to like go for it. Let's do some of the random questions. One question asked, I saw it earlier, is what is my favorite perfume? So I have to go get it. I really want to show you guys because I like this perfume a lot, so I want to show you what I'm using. Okay, so my favorite perfume is called Mademoiselle by Chanel. So this is the bottle that it's actually an empty bottle because I recently ran out. But I've been using this perfume for like the last 15 years, like no lie. And actually in my last vlog, I think I edited it out, but when my brother was here in town, I went to the mall, and I bought more. And this time I bought the Intense version. So this is like the Etude perfume. I don't speak French, so I'm probably saying that wrong. But I went ahead and bought the Intense version. The lady talked me into it, and I was really like skeptical because but I decided to try something different, and it was like $30 more, I don't know, but the smell is a little bit more intense. It's kind of the same though, and the reason that I love this so much is probably like maybe like 10 years or so ago, so I had been wearing it, but I was going home and I would visit my family every time I would go home because I'm in the Navy. And so my nieces and nephews would always like tell me like they like the way I smell. And so one of my nephews, he used to be like, Auntie, why do you smell like that? And I'm like what? He's like that. And I'm like, Troy, like what? And he's like fresh flowers. And I was like, oh my God. It was the cutest thing ever. And I was like, I'm never changing my perfume. And so honestly, I have not. I love it. I probably buy a bottle like maybe once a year, maybe. It depends. This is what I use every day, and then every once in a while if I'm like going out or trying to do something special, then I'll use actually a cheaper perfume, but it's just because it smells different, and so that kind of like changes up the vibe. But this is like my everyday perfume. Let's see, the next one says, what's your favorite drink? My favorite drink personally is lemonade. Like I'll probably, if I go out, then I'm gonna be buying lemonade. Like if I'm going out to dinner, then I'm gonna have lemonade like with my dinner. If I go like buy juice and stuff for the house, it's some type of flavored lemonade. So I would say probably lemonade. But if you're from Cleveland or if you're from Detroit or kind of anywhere in the Midwest, then you probably know about Faygo Peach Pop. I love Faygo Peach Pop. But I don't drink pop that often, and so I can't really say it's like my favorite because I probably haven't had it in like 3 or 4 years, maybe even more, because I, like I said, I don't drink pop. But when I get it, Oh my god, it is the best. If y'all don't know about Fago Peach Pop, try it and thank me later. I'm telling you. What's your favorite movie? My favorite movie is Love Jones. I love that movie. Like, I can't stress it enough how much I love that movie. I can probably watch that movie every day. In fact, like, whenever I'm like moving from one state to another, or like doing a PTS move in the Navy, like, I'll take my little small like portable laptop or portable DVD player, and I'll bring Love Jones. And so no matter where I go, sorry, it's probably loud in the background. No matter where I go, like, I can watch Love Jones, and that can be like my entertainment. My favorite song is from the soundtrack of Love Jones, which is not really a song, but it's kind of like a composed piece called In a Sentimental Mood. And I believe it's by Coltrane. It's actually my ringtone. I wonder if I can find it, and I'll let you guys hear a little snippet of it. But Love Jones is my absolute favorite movie. When I was in Chicago, or stationed kind of near Chicago, I was like thinking like, oh my god, I'm gonna find like my perfect man down here. He's gonna be just like Darius. And I did end up finding my man, but not when I was stationed in Chicago, but we re-met when I was on a random vacation in New Orleans. Different story for a different time, but he gave me all the vibes because then he moved to Chicago with me and I just loved it. Okay, let me find it. Hold on. I wanted to play. By John Coltrane. So that's my favorite song plus my favorite movie. So that was kind of a two for one question. Let's go back to Instagram. What's your 5-year goals as an entrepreneur? Ooh, entrepreneur. So first of all, I gotta tell you guys, I'm like kind of really getting comfortable with calling myself an entrepreneur, because I never thought that I would be kind of doing a job that I was working for myself, kind of creating like my own business. And here I am just kind of full on doing it. And that's with my trucking company. And it's also with my Elaine Essentials, which is my baby, my natural hair oils that I love so much. So let's talk about 5-year goals with that, because I really don't get into the details much about my trucking company, because that is something that's a lot more technical. It's like a lot of ins and outs that are behind the scenes with that, that I'm just not as comfortable kind of talking about all the time. But my natural hair oil, I can talk about all day, every day. So, Elaine Essentials Natural Hair Oils. Follow us on Instagram. You can email us at elaine.essentials@gmail.com. And you can find me on Facebook at Elaine Essentials. This oil, I love it. So, my goals, I would say my number one goal is to get a website, which I'm holding off on doing that because right now I'm still about 3 months old in this kind of business. And what I want to do is kind of really stir up some, what's the word I'm looking for? Like some excitement. Like, I want people to kind of hear about it. I want people to kind of use it. I want people to kind of get that word of mouth out there first before I really invest my time, energy, and money into a website. But for sure, within the next 5 years, even within the next year, I want to have a website. I want to be able to have, to really see like a profit that will mirror my day job profit margin, or kind of the salary that I get from my day job. I'd like to see that from Elaine Essentials. So, I mean, I will essentially like to save all the money that I get from working in the Navy and to really just use Elaine Essentials to supplement my life. Because ultimately that's when I get out of the Navy, I don't want to work another job. I'm going to retire and I'll kind of have my retirement coming in, and I don't want to work anything else unless I choose to, which I probably will still do like therapy services. But so I want Elaine Essentials to be able to supplement my lifestyle. And I want it to be a household name. Like, in the next 5 years, I want people to kind of look at Elaine Essentials as kind of like that absolute, like, you know, hair necessity. Like when you go to the shop, you want to ask like, oh, what kind of oil are you using? Oh, I want you to use the Elaine Essentials. Like those are my 5-year goals, I would say, for Elaine Essentials. Great question. Let's go back to the random questions. Let's see. What's your favorite holiday? My favorite holiday is Christmas. Like I love Christmas. Like, okay, so I like Thanksgiving a lot, and I love kind of the fall and the vibe of the fall. But I don't really get the feel of it, especially right now, being that I'm in San Diego, and like I can look outside and there's like a palm tree outside. The sun is like shining bright. It was 90 degrees this weekend. It doesn't feel like fall. Otherwise, I would probably say Thanksgiving. But Christmas, no matter where I am in the world, I love Christmas. I'm probably going to have the same issues as far as it being sunny and bright and palm trees on Christmas, but it doesn't matter. My house is going to be decorated. I'm cooking. I'm buying all the gifts. I love buying gifts for people. I love wrapping gifts. I just love the vibe. I love the celebration of Jesus. I love being around family. I love Christmas. So for sure, Christmas is my favorite holiday. Absolutely. Have I been out of the country? Why, yes. I mentioned before, I'm in the Navy. My first duty station was in Okinawa, Japan. I was stationed in Yokosuka, Japan, which is really close to Tokyo. I was in Afghanistan again for the Navy. I've traveled leisurely to Germany to visit my brother. Traveled to Thailand. I've traveled to the Dominican Republic. I think those are my out-of-country travels. I might be forgetting something, but yes, I've been out of the country. How tall am I? I'm 5'4", so I would say that's pretty average. What would you name your children? Or if I had children, what would I name? Or what are their names? So I don't have children. I always like the names that are kind of like, can be girl or boy, but I know my guy is like not for it at all. But initially, I love the name Ryan because I felt like Ryan can be a girl's name, it can be a boy's name, either one. I love the name Caden. Like, again, for me, honestly, girl or boy, but probably more girl, more boy. If I had a girl, I just thought, I can't remember. I had a very beautiful name. I told my guy, he was kind of like, blah about it. But either way, whatever like daughter I have, I really want her to have my middle name, Elaine, because my mom gave me her middle name. And I just want to kind of pass that down. And at one point I was thinking like Rose Elaine, because that's kind of cute. And roses remind me of my mom, and then Elaine. But Rose is kind of an old name. I don't want to do that to my daughter. Dang, I had a really nice name. And I can't remember. Oh, Nola. Nola Elaine. And the reason I like Nola is because me and my guy, we kind of reconnected in New Orleans. And it was so random. You know, they call like New Orleans like Nola, like New Orleans, Louisiana. And I just thought that was a very pretty name. But he kind of looked at me like, whatever. So we'll see. Stand by in a year or two when I have my daughter. Mark my words. What was your reason for joining the military, and do you ever regret your decision? So I joined the Navy originally about almost 13 years ago, and I joined on like a buddy program with one of my homegirls, and she actually like really convinced me to join the Navy. I was out of high school for like a year. I was in college, but you know, I was kind of like, you know, I was going to have to pay for college, and she's like, you know, the Navy will pay for college. You don't have to really worry about debt or loans or things like that. And she really sold me on it. And especially because it was like this buddy program, because before then I had never really left Cleveland. And so I'm like, okay, yeah, I'll do it. And what happened is she ended up not being able to go. And so I was like really, really scared and nervous. And I'm like, oh my God, I cannot believe this. So I thought that I was obligated to go, even though she couldn't. And so I still went ahead with it, and I went to boot camp and everything. It turns out I didn't have to. Like, I could have opted out at any point, and I just didn't really know, and the recruiters didn't tell me. But I don't regret it. The Navy has afforded me the opportunity to, you know, pay for all of my college. I've gotten my associate degree, my bachelor's degree, my master's degree, debt-free. I've met the best people, like all of my best friends I've met in the Navy. My current boyfriend, we met when he was in the Navy back in the day. So no regrets. I really love the Navy, and I'm so thankful for joining the Navy. Let's see, let's do one or two more of the random questions. Let's see. It says dogs or cats. I love cats, but I haven't had a cat. And the last time I had a cat, it was a bad experience. Like, that little kitten was crazy. I, like, paid probably, like, $500 in adoption fees and, like, buying all the stuff. And I literally gave the cat away on Craigslist because it was so crazy. So, I would probably say now that I'm getting older, maybe dogs. Or I would, like, adopt, like, an older cat that's not, like, little and crazy. What are your life goals? Oh my gosh, this is a heavy question. So I'm going to probably end it with this question because I have something I need to run and do. But I would say my life goals kind of really fall in line with like my 5-year entrepreneurship goals, or those are a part of it. But I would say ultimately, I really want to touch people. And I say that in a way of meaning like I really want to make a difference and make an impact on people's lives. I'm a very quiet person. Like if you met me in person in real life and like walked past me, you would think that I was so quiet because I don't necessarily like open conversation with people or things like that. But in my professional job, I'm a social worker, and so I do a lot of individual and group counseling. And when I'm in those rooms and in those sessions with those people, like those moments are life changing, not only for them, for me too, because it shows me what I'm capable of. And I love that feeling. Like I love being able to walk in a room and sit down with a person and to kind of, you know, say something to them or do something with them that really has an impact on their lives. And so my life goal is to just to continue to do that with as many people as possible. That includes kind of like my dream of having like this type of organization where, you know, I'm from Cleveland, Ohio, which is kind of an inner city. I was raised in, you know, I love my family in the way that I was raised, but it was a very impoverished neighborhood. Before I was adopted, you know, I lived in a house. We didn't have any lights. We didn't have any running water. My mom was sick. She was in the hospital with cancer. And it was just a very impoverished situation. And when I think about it and I kind of see where I am now, I've grown into become like this person that I would have never expected that little girl who was in that situation back then probably would have never known. And so what I want to do is to be able to go back to areas like that, back to Cleveland, maybe other places like New York and Atlanta and, you know, all these places where people are living impoverished, and to show them that you can make it out. And so I want to have like this, you know, organization where, you know, maybe other successful people who've come from places like that can come back and to show the kids like, hey, listen, there is life outside of their current circumstance. You do not have to stay here. You can leave. You can go to school. You can become whoever you want to become. And it doesn't have to be a person, you know, playing basketball or rapping lyrics. You know, you can go to school and you can really become a professional, or you can become an entrepreneur, or you can do both. Like, I'm literally the proof that you can really do whatever you want to do. And I know that, you know, that can be such a cliche to say you can be whoever you want to be, but no, you really can. And I want to be able to go back and kind of touch people and show them that. And even adults that are kind of living in their, you know, their grief about maybe their past or situation that they've been through. Like, I just want to touch people's lives. But yeah, like I said, I really have to go. So I hope that you guys enjoyed this kind of get to know me a little bit. My goal is to be able to just let you guys know kind of the person behind all these random videos, you know, the lock videos, which I love, the braces videos, the vlogs that are kind of like this new thing that I'm kind of trying and I'm really starting to like and I want to get more into it. So if you want to see more, definitely comment below. If you have some specific questions you want to ask me, I'm happy to answer them. I'll do either another video or I'll answer you directly in the comment section. You can always find me on Instagram at Rebecca Elaine. While you're there, you can go ahead and follow my business page at Elaine Essentials. And I will see you guys on the next one. Bye.